Ladies and gentlemen.
Hello?
Yeah. It's official. It's real late. Hot 97. He's back. Boy Sand, Queens finest. Homeboy Sandman's back in the building.
Queens.
How you doing, bro?
I'm good, man. How are you?
I'm doing good, man. I feel great, man. Thanks for having me on.
You have, of course, first of all, door's always open. And you have a new album.
Yeah, Dusty.
Dusty.
Yeah.
And it's out?
Yeah, it's out December 18th. Oh, it's October 18th.
October 18th.
So depending on the date today, I'm not that good with dates.
It's out right now.
It's out as we speak.
and what's the deal with this project? You putting it out independent?
Nah, it's on Mellow Music.
It's on Mellow? All right, yeah. Shout out to Mellow Music.
So big shout out to Mellow Music. And it's my first full length on Mellow. It's produced entirely by my boy Mono and Stereo, formerly LRTNC, when he did the Cool Herc Fertile Crescent record with me.
Mm-hmm.
And we've been doing joints together forever. And I love it. I think it's a special record and what have you.
What's your life? What's the Boy Sand life journey been recently? I hope that during this interview, how many times have you done the show before? Two, three?
Shoot, I think this is my second time, actually.
This is the only second time you've done
it? Because the first time, I went and kicked it with you someplace else.
Okay.
And then we taped it over there. So that was the one time. This might be the third time.
And then maybe the other time you came and spit or something?
Yeah, because I was here another time.
I want to, with this interview, try to introduce, because I think a lot of the listening audience and people who lock in on Sunday nights would enjoy, you know, the life that is Homeboy Sandman. How do I convey that to the audience? What you are as a person, how you operate, shoot, how you move around. Where are you living these days?
I live in Brooklyn.
And how long you been there?
I've been there 4 or 5 years.
Same spot?
Same spot, you know, which is...
That's interesting for you.
Yeah, it is interesting for me. It's very... very unusual, you know, that type of...
You used to be moving around constantly, location wise.
Yeah. But even within that time, you know, I've left that place alone for 7 months at a time, you know, half a year, you know. But I've been keeping returning to it, so it's cool. But I guess I've been a little bit more, you know, I got the baby with me now. So I got my girl Lisa with me. So I used to feel like I could sleep on the train, if anything, and that just made it cool to just let go of anything. So I feel like I don't want my girl sleeping on the train. So I do like to have an apartment in a stash. You know what I'm saying?
That makes sense. Where else have you lived? Where else have you lived during this time?
I lived in Sweden for 7 months. That was cool.
When was that?
That was in 2017. I live in Stockholm. That was real flavor. I like that a lot. And mostly Stockholm, but, you know, all around Sweden. I lived in Williamsburg for a couple months.
Well, real quick. So when you living in Sweden, do you pay any... I know you're not normally caught up on current events, necessarily, of the hip-hop world. Did you pay attention to the ASAP Rocky Sweden story at all?
Well, my boy ASAP Rock...
yeah. Who I once famously introduced
right,
to ASAP
yeah.
Rocky.
And I said on video.
Yeah, yeah.
My father sent me, I do stay out of the loop, but my father did send me a text saying, you know, I heard about your boy. I hope everything's okay with him. And
were you surprised by the story, though, like that a situation like that would occur? Or were you like, I could see that happening?
Aside from the mix-up, it was ASAP Rocky, not ASAP Rock.
Mm-hmm.
That my father was talking about.
Oh, and that's why
he was
confused.
Exactly. Yeah, my father was like, oh, that's Angel's boy, you know?
Right. Because you're tight with Aesop Rock.
Yeah, because Aesop Rock.
I don't know Rocky.
Right. Yeah, I don't know Rocky, but, you know, I mean, I don't like captivity. You know, I don't know what the situation is. I hope he's free. And
he ended up being free.
That's awesome.
But I was just curious, based on your experience in Sweden, whether you would be surprised that a black American artist would have, you know, someone follow them and act kind of crazy.
Yeah.
Because Rocky got put in a pretty tough situation.
Yeah, I guess that could happen anywhere. You know, somebody could follow you. My experience in Sweden, I didn't meet nobody remotely malicious in any sense. You know, it was...
So you liked the lifestyle there?
Yeah, I loved it. Everybody's real sweet and kind, yo.
Where else have you lived in the world? Anywhere else?
I lived all over America. No, not all over America. I lived all over New York. And I guess... I travel a lot and, you know, sometimes stay in the UK for a while, you know, spent a month in PR once or something like that. But I guess I'm mostly in New York for the most part.
And musically, where would you say you are right now? Because you constantly sort of develop as an MC. You don't really stay in the same place. Yeah. Like, you don't keep a pocket for that long. Your pocket is someplace, and then sort of develops, and you go someplace else.
Right.
What is this version we're getting on Dusty of Homeboy Sandman?
Dag, Dusty is a version that is no longer with us, you know what I'm saying? But was with us for this record. And, you know, and I really love what he was able to do on the music tip. Some of the stuff that he's saying, I'll be like, pfft. But he can rhyme and it's crazy ill. You know, like I listened to it.
When did you record this?
Started about 2 years ago. Or started writing it about maybe 2 years ago to 2.5 years ago and finished recording it maybe 6 to 7 months ago. And you know, there's varying varieties of mental fluctuation on it. But, you know, you talk about like where I am as, you know, a person and all that. And you know, I don't ever really know, you know what I'm saying? Today especially, but also every single day, you know what I mean? Like, I came through the house, you know, we were smoking big weed, and I loved it, you know what I'm saying? I was like, I'm blowing trees.
If that's one way to call it, big weed, okay.
I was a one-hit wonder, but.
Yo, Shawty, he was a one-hit wonder, for real. It was different.
But I was high for a month, March Madness, and I felt like that was 2.0. Dusty's right. Actually 2.0, there's varieties, there's no 2.1, like now I'm 2.1 version, which is, you know, post 2.0, but...
Because you're off the smoking again then.
I'm off trees now. You know, big shout to trees. Big shout to everybody.
How long? Now, real quick, for the story, when you were a kid, when did you smoke weed? At what ages?
I mean, I smoked weed from, you know, like the teen years, probably, you know, to the late 20s.
And where did you go to college?
Pennsylvania, University of Pennsylvania.
And were you playing ball?
I played a little bit of ball. But, you know, I started my eligibility, but... Not enough to say I played ball there, you know?
And then you got into the weed and rapping instead.
I got into, well, the truth is, you know, like, I didn't even get into rapping. I rapped a little bit, you know what I'm saying? But the truth, you know, with the ball team, I felt like I had to go to all these practices and all that. And I wasn't even getting, it's a long story, but I started smoking weed, yeah.
And you opted for that.
Yeah, I opted for that. I opted for the you know, the college, you know, chasing tail, you know what I'm saying?
Getting high and drinking.
Yeah, exactly. And the thing was, I was on a JV club because they didn't have a walk-on, you know, you had to play JV. I don't want to get into all this, but I didn't have the patience to just chill. And I was like, yo, I'm doing all this disciplinary stuff. Nobody even knows I'm on a team. None of the chicks know I'm on a team.
Right, you and that's what your priority was at
yes.
the time. Right.
Yes. So you and were probably like, even today, to this day, that's my only priority. That's what I gotta fix. You know what I'm saying?
Well, that's a problem a lot of people have to fix.
Yeah.
But when did you get super serious about rap?
In 2006, in December 2006, you know, when I finally stopped, you know, being high all the time and was like... you know, I'm a kick rhymes, but you know, like we knew each other. I
right around
when you first came to New York, you know?
Which was 07.
Yeah, yeah.
So that tape that you gave me with Air Raid,
yeah, that was my second album that came out in 2008. You know, my first one came out in 2007.
And this is still you giving out CDs.
Yeah, yeah, giving out
with
CDs
with the black back, you know, yeah, the plastic
yeah.
front.
Hell yeah,
the
yeah,
little thin
yeah.
jewel case CDs.
Yeah, yeah, that I used to get done up in Mosa, up in Harlem. Yo, shout to them.
How did you navigate to getting a music career in which you don't have to conform to anything, you do whatever it is you want musically, mm-hmm. and you may not be rich, but you live a nice life just off of music all the time?
Shoot, it's a good situation. I guess I would just say, you know, all the glory be to God on that one. You know, I don't really have too much of a plan. I'm really lucky, you know, that I just keep getting hooked up in one way or another. You know what I mean? You know, you talk about the financial stability, like that's, there's just always, some always comes, you know? Some always comes and fills in the gap, you know? Whether it be some type of ramen opportunity or some type of ally, you know what I mean? They got big bread or whatever, you know what I mean? Like, you know, shouts to my boy P, you know? I'm always getting hooked up by God, you know, the universe, whatever. For me, God, All I got, you know, I feel like I just got to kick these rhymes and try to be, you know, I'm kind of, I feel like I just got to kick these rhymes and try to be me. You know what I mean? I think that's the reason why, you know, this is my 18th release, Dusty. You know, I think it's my 9th LP, but it's my 18th between EPs and all this stuff. And, you know, I just keep writing because I just got to keep writing just because I'm nervous. You know what I mean? Like, you know, so I don't really,
you consider yourself a nervous person? Because I don't know if I would have described you that way. I feel like you're so comfortable in every situation.
Yeah, well, I kind of feel like, I don't know. In my mind, I feel like I'm nervous, you know? I mean, I'm too nervous in my mind to really be nervous about what's going on outside. That don't really compare at all to the jungle in my mind. You know what I'm saying? Like, in my mind, I want to do what's right, you know? And I'm like, you know, when I first started rhyming and we first met, like, I had this grandiose, yo, I'm going to be Homeboy Sandman, you know, the Bill and Ted of rap, change the world with the raps, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to be so ill with the raps that people are going to be nice to each other, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And I felt that way. That was what drove me, you know what I mean? I don't feel that way anymore. I still want to rhyme. What makes me want to rhyme now? Oh, I want the girls to like me, you know what I'm saying? I kick a rhyme for that. Oh, I need to get paid. I kick a rhyme for that. I need to jump. I kick a rhyme for that. You know.
Is that a record? You just wrote a record right now. I kick a rhyme for that with all these different topics.
Facts. It's hot. I want to
hit. Do you, what I'm going to say could sound startlingly offensive, or you could be like, no, I see what you're saying. Is there another world in which a few things go differently and you are just a rambling crazy man on the street?
It might be this world. You know what I'm saying?
No, some could argue it's actually just what's happening. Yeah. But like, you know, a world in which, like, for example, you've come to every home I've had in New York. You've come to my house, hung out at my wedding. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah, you're real, man.
But
beautiful.
Like, there is a world in which I'd be like, yo, I met that dude. He was a rapper once. Now he's just a crazy man. He'll say anything on the street. Because you do live by the seat of your pants and you just have your own philosophies. You're very non-judgmental, but you have strong feelings. You're just an interesting cat. Like, I've just never known another you.
Yeah, well, good. I take that. I like that. You know what I'm saying? I take that as a compliment. You know what I'm saying? Because one thing that instinctually makes my skin crawl is uniformity and similarity, at least with regards to me. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So that's something that feels like it's actually in there that I got to try to. But the world of me just being a crazy person walking around the street, that might just be the world in 2 months. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't really know. You know, if I find out, yo, I'm really just supposed to walk the street and be crazy, and that's where I get my little Zen peace from, that's what I'll do right away, you know?
But you do feel at peace right now.
Right now, I feel kind of frazzled, dazzled, you know, for the past little while. But, you know, Dusty is a crazy record. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't blame me, you know. Don't blame the record, you know, for me. But yeah, I mean, you know, on the record you could hear that I got this joint called Noteworthy that you know, I think is a real good look inside my head. I really love it. And you know, the whole album is a look inside my head.
Yeah. You put out a couple of projects with Stone's Throw.
Yeah, what up?
You've had a few different label situations. Mm-hmm. And now you have the Mellow situation. What up? Do you have a preference in terms of how you put out music from a business standpoint?
I mean, I will say that, like, I like to put out a ton of stuff as much as I can. You know what I mean? Like, I can't put out, you know, I will put out something monthly or bi-monthly. You know what I mean? If it didn't feel like that was just oversaturating or making it. It seems like putting out a release a year is, you know, is what makes the most economic sense or whatever.
In terms of the time and what you can get
out
of that project.
And then, you know, you do the tour cycle after that.
So what's your current tour situation? You touring again soon?
Yeah. I'm going to be touring in November, do the East Coast in November, do the West down to Colorado in February, going to be in Europe in March, going to be in middle America, Midwest or whatever in April. That's and hopefully going to be in Australia and New Zealand in May.
And where would you say you do the best? Where are there the most Homeboy Sandman fans?
I mean, according to according to, you know, the internet data, is New York. You know what I'm saying? But I feel like I got shouted out a lot more in other places. You know what I mean?
What does it feel like to you? not the data, but just to you, what does it feel like?
I mean, I love New York. You know, we had a couple shows in New York that was great. I definitely feel the love in New York. Let me not.
Yeah, you don't want to brush over that. Yeah, it's real to get love
feel,
at home.
Yeah. I feel the love in New York. I feel the love in Cali. You know what I'm saying? For sure. You know, Stone Stove being out there. You know, I definitely feel the love.
I'm a regular. I spend a lot of time giving Cali credit. I always feel like L.A. has one of the best underground hip-hop scenes in the country.
Yeah, absolutely.
And definitely. People sleep on that.
Yeah. They've been having that whole Project Blow, you know, jumping for a long time. A lot of cats came out because of Open Mike Eagle, my boy Verbs over there. And
Open Mike Eagle's doing good.
Huh? Yeah, absolutely.
He's making moves right now.
He did that comedy thing that was wild, the New Negroes.
And I know of Open Mike Eagle first because of you.
Is it really?
I think so.
Oh, that's cool.
Well,
that's
you guys
cool.
did shows together or record?
We've done a joint that for him that I'm not sure came out. We did a joint for me that hasn't come out, and we did a joint with Aesop that did come out.
And what about you? Done shows too or no?
Yeah, we done shows. We done a tour actually.
Oh, you did a tour.
We did a tour. Right.
Maybe
yeah,
that's where I first saw it.
Yeah. But he's a great dude, man. He's a great talent.
Really good sound, funny, smart, interesting cat. Shouts to Open Mikey. Okay. Anyways, but so you get to tour all over the place. Just continue to put this music out. Is there anyone out there in the game that you would really like to work with that you haven't?
Yeah. You know, I've been working more with Quelle Chris.
You've been telling me about Quelle Chris.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of his. You know what I mean? And collaborating with him is fun. Who else?
You're very picky when it comes to MCs that you really think are dope and challenge you.
Yeah, I guess I am.
If I'm being honest, I play you stuff sometimes and I can tell you're like,
I mean, I really do, you know, I feel like, you know, there's a handful of dudes. I'm very comfortable shouting out Open Mike Eagle, Odyssey, you know, Quelle, Kemba, you know, Jay-Z, you know what I mean? I'm not just trying to shout out cats that are people are not familiar with, you know?
You like Slick Rick?
Slick Rick, I love. Of course, yeah, Slick Rick. You know, but I mean, back in the days, everybody knew the nice cats. You know what I'm saying? So
right. Now there's so many people.
Yeah, now there's so many people, but there's still only a few nice cats in my mind. You know what I mean?
Is there anyone out that's currently out there that you think is nice that's gotten your attention that you've been like, oh, you know, let me check into this a little more?
There's some of the names that I mentioned. And then, you know, my boy Aesop Rock, of course. And then...
Have you ever, of the new artists that are out? Have you heard DaBaby ever?
I haven't heard DaBaby, nah.
You've heard his name?
I heard it, yeah, I heard his name, sure.
You want to hear what he sounds like?
All right, no doubt, yeah, sure.
I'm going to play you a couple records. Let's play a couple records for Boy Sand, okay?
All right.
Just give you a minute, here we go.
Let's go. You know it's baby, nigga.
This guy's the hottest guy out right now.
Yeah, no doubt.
She wanna fuck with me, but I don't got the time. Just hopped off a private plane and went and hopped on 85. Go cut my chauffeur, bitch, cause I don't like to drive. Yeah, Suburban's back to back and we gon' fill them up with vibes.
The baby, that's off of Kirk, that's vibes.
Yeah.
I know it's different, not your typical speed. What do you think? What do you hear? What do you think?
You catch me on a unique day.
Okay.
On a normal day, I would say... That's cool. You know, that's cool. I think it's cool. You know, I think it's cool. You know.
Lyrically, it's not pushing you anywhere.
Yeah. But, you know, like, you know, obviously, you know, shouts to DaBaby, respect. And it ain't for me to validate DaBaby or nothing like that. I can only speak for me.
Right.
And say that for me, you know, I think it's cool. You know what I mean? Like, I think it's cool. Yeah, I think I'll keep it there. You know, trying to think of anything else I could say just because of where I'm at today, like...
Well, you're doing a water fast today, too.
I'm doing a water fast today,
not a lot of calories in there.
Yeah, I love cats. I love cats. Yeah, shouts to the baby. I love cats, you know, that I'm like, yo, I, you know, like...
That challenge, that push you, lyrically. Style-wise.
Yeah. Forward. I just, you know, but everybody different. Everybody listen to music for different reasons.
What do you think of that? Let's play my boy.
Does Kendrick get any props?
I've heard some Kendrick that I was impressed by. You know, when I was in the gym one day, they played a joint. I think he was rapping on a Beyonce joint. Mm-hmm. And another, I really do be out the loop, but the first joint that put him on, my boy DJ Hov sent me, was the one with the horns. I can't remember what it's called, but
it was from his first album?
It was back in the day. It was like a while ago. Yeah, before he really took off. So mm-hmm. And I'm not, you know, like, there's all types of dudes that are I think I'm into a specific thing, you know, like I'm into a specific type of surgery, maybe, or even, you know, a specific type of like energy, maybe. You know what
you
I mean?
Do you love Doom?
Yeah, Supervillain Doom, I do love, true.
You like, because you like people who push it and take you to places that are not, let's be honest, just not totally straightforward. Straight
plus,
ahead.
Plus, I like, you know, like kicking it with Doom, you know, I feel like I had to kick it with Doom to kick it with Doom. I can't kick it with Joe and it be like I'm kicking it with Doom, or kick it with Michael and it be like I'm kicking it with Doom.
I mean, Doom's his original.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And it's just, for me, that's what I'm looking for, you know, in film and music and books. You know, I don't like things that remind me of other stuff. I already got reminded of that thing. You know what I mean? I'm running out of time. Hours are getting shorter every second. Who knows when they're going to stop? What can I fill this with to get some new stimulus? You know what I'm saying? I'm looking for some new stimulus.
I'm going to play you a joint off of Mac Miller's last album. Mac's a guy who I think also, there was only one person. There was one version. Let's play you this.
Yeah. The world is so small till it ain't. Yeah. I'm building up a wall till it break. She hate it when I call and it's late. I don't wanna keep you waiting. I hope I never keep you waiting. The world is so small.
I would think that you might enjoy this album. It's very, it just floats on its own path.
Right.
You know what
right,
I'm saying?
I thought that was an enjoyable listening experience, man. You know, I you know, there was some stuff that I found creative and artistic in there.
Yeah.
And it just seemed to me like white boys are allowed to be nice, you know? People put me on the nice white boys that everybody knows.
Right.
And it just seems to me like as a white boy, you could be nice.
And still be popping, you're saying?
Yeah. You could be nice. You could be,
right.
You know what I'm saying? Artistic and out and on your own tip. You could be on your own tip. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, and you know, there's all types of theories and all that. I'm not even saying that the first, you know, obviously my reaction to this is different from the baby or whatever. You know,
of course.
But I don't hear nothing. I don't hear anything. But without hearing anything, I feel like I've heard stuff like the baby before.
Got it.
You know,
Mac, you hear like this is different.
Yeah,
someone's
I was like, you know what I'm saying? That's cool. And
you feel like people are and by the way, Mac's the first person who I think would agree with that conversation. He always felt, I think, as a white artist, like he had more to prove because he wanted to show everyone how much he could rap. So the first several projects were like, I'm going to show everyone I can rap my ass off. But then he got to settle into a little bit of the privilege you're allowed to have when you're white, which is now I grew up with my parents loving the Beatles and all kinds of stuff. And now I can go that way. And yes, people will go with you.
Right,
whereas
right.
Like black artists have more of a pressure if you've been accepted on mainstream radio in that area to kind of stay in a place where you're considered popping. Otherwise it's like, oh, you fell off.
It could be that.
What
yeah,
are you doing?
It could be. But I mean, if cats came out and was still getting hyped up, even as they went through their creative things or whatever, people would say they was popping. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
like,
right.
It just seemed like, you know, my boy Dwight put me on to the other kid, Logic. He go, you listen to Logic? I like Logic. He put me on, sent me some joints. I was like, oh, there's bars here. You
bars,
know?
Yeah, Roger Crap.
You know what I'm saying? But I'm just saying, like, I know cats got bars that I send to you, but nobody knows who they are. You sending me this cat, everybody knows who it is. If I sent you that cat, and it's just that type of thing, but it's whatever, you know what I'm
saying? I'll tell you this. Logic Logic's an amazing rapper, in my opinion. Logic, if he looked differently, would he be as huge a sensation as he is, considering what he's really good at is just being a great rapper. Because for a lot of black artists, that was not enough. Mm-hmm. Being a great rapper, you were underground. Like, that was it. You were underground. And Logic is, I know I'm making judgment on Logic's racial background, as he's spoken a lot on record. I know, of course, he's biracial. But in terms of what he appears like to people and the acceptance he's able to get, yeah, it changes the standards completely, which is super fascinating. But anyways, I just wanted to play different things and get Homeboy Sandman's take. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Now you want to give the people a taste of what Homeboy Sandman does?
Yeah, sure.
Your headphones good?
Yeah, everything sounds pretty
Homeboy
good.
Homeboy Sandman's in the building. It's real late. Hot 97. Where, yeah, you have volume. No, you just have volume in front of you if you want your headphones up.
Let me see. Yeah, okay, cool.
It's real late. Hot 97, Queens own. Dusty's out right now. Homeboy Sandman's here.
Queens.
Angel from Elmhurst. You know what I mean?
Check it out, word up. Conductor Mad Lib on the Blue Note Records, keeping the funk alive.
Nothing to take light. Don't take drugs. Pornhub is a great site. I ain't never wanted to play fight. Murderer, I heard it through the grapevine, hidden in plain sight. Bit of media for feeding the trolls on my mistake of shaking, rattling, roll. If I'm a little out of control, it's only because I don't have home training. Ain't no taking orders in the waters, I's waiting. Sharpening on minor marketing can help to hit the target I's aiming. Pull along the side of as I strive to be alive without complaining. I don't want my training being confused with entertainment. I just want the payment. Teleport a pound on the pavement. Matador, man and woman, proud to be a pagan. Word of mama, motorcon, coat of arms, suit of armor just for the occasion. For the abrasion. As a kid, I wanted to grow to be a secret agent. Except the CDs brought me overseas to sleep with Asians. Could have been worse. This Google bar search putting in work. Diversion at the virgin at birth. Few to one and meet apocalypse. Grand a gift for water and earth. And save a quarter mill or order reverse church. Turn it up louder. Then recording, I was snorting protein powder to the umpteenth power. Several hundred million years ahead of breaking legs and making bread without flour. Baking cookies in the 25th hour once the milk is going sour. So I'm making extra buttery, shove it in the bottom on a honeybee. Underground for now, but not for long, cause when I'm going, they're gonna study me. Every cut I handle cutlery. Being honest, swear to God, I wish I had some comp to keep me company. I'm winning too comfortably. For sport, I think they should resort to trying to sort a cold duggery, but that'd just be tomfoolery. Something like an order bot is born to rock, and every time I take it from the top, I drop jewelry gems. Growing up, my state of mind was us against them. Nowadays, I think it doesn't hardly make sense, cause I hardly make friends. Most time, the only time I ever press send is asking a producer if they please to send stems. Pension is for taking it to the furthest extent. Professor X invited me to join the X-Men, but I didn't accept. I think that I was on my way to cash checks. I catch wreck. Every month I'm on a honeymoon. Honey move like honeydews and cantaloupes. Maximally in the mood because I'm immune to medicines and antidotes. As such, I overdose. I'm not the one that uses tragedy to self-promote, but whatever floats your boat, folks. My reputation's solid gold, so I'm good to go on both coasts. So everybody want to take me to lunch and come to hot step or just a hop, skip, and a jump from on the spot. And anytime the brother drop, you can hit a kerplunk. Anytime the brother rock, you had better pull up. Car, train, or the bus. In the rush, fill your cup. Trying to interrupt, you'll be in the rut. Yup. Took me just a couple minutes. Of course, you had it spinning. Got it popping like Popeye and spinach. You was just sitting duck.
Homeboy Sandman, ladies and gentlemen. Right. It's real late, Hot 97. Yo, Shawnee's,
fire, fire.
Shawnee's here a lot with me on these. Yeah. Yo, the complexity of bars and how effortlessly he did that in one take. The amount of times that you guys don't know that we have to like stop the cameras and the recording to redo things because people can't get through their bars, no disrespect, that are like a tenth as complicated to get through.
Nah, he's a true artist. He takes his craft seriously, man.
And stay in pocket. Like, it's not just about bars, but man, like.
Yeah, that pocket is hard.
That pocket right there, when I heard this instrumental, when we played it, I was like, what is he going to do to
this? It's fast.
It's super fast.
You're running on it. Dancing on it.
Yeah,
we zigzagging.
Shawnee was just like, What did you say when we first turned on the beat?
Well, you asked me what sample is this.
Yeah,
I was first like, well, I don't. It sounds familiar, but I don't know. And you said it's the Electric Relaxation Tribe Called Quest.
Yeah,
and I was like, oh, this fast.
Yeah, it's fast though. It's super fast.
But I know he can handle it. Homeboy Sandman's the name.
Yo, good looking out.
Dusty's
man.
Out right now. Brother, the door is always open. Whether you're putting out albums or a vagrant walking in the street.
Yo. Brother, I love you, Ben.
I love you too,
yo,
man.
You know, it's good to be in the house, man.
Always.
You always been representing. Yo, big shout out to my boy Peter Rosenberg, who's always been representing.
Yo, thank you, man. And to you too, who's always.
And I don't just
love.
Mean me, I mean everybody, yo.
Nah, no doubt. Yo, by the way, I talked about you on the show last week. Did anybody hit you?
Nah, that must be one of. Well, actually, last week was a weird week for me, so maybe people did hit me.
Because normally he's the one artist that whenever I mention him, I get a text the next day like, "Yo, I heard you said something."
Yeah,
about
I always get
night.
Hit. That could have happened last week.
Yo, Boy Sand, Dusty's out right now. Thank you, man.
Yeah, thank you. Peace.
Throwback's next.